This week on Moms Like Us, Coco Austin explains why she allows co-sleeping in her home.
Isa and I, we have a different way of thinking. We call our bed the family bed.
Then Jason Momoa reveals why he isn't a big fan of his kids following in his acting footsteps.
So I can see this. I feel like a lot of people in the industry want their kids to do something different, I think, because being in the spotlight and that whole thing, right?
Plus, Beyonce shares her most satisfying part of parenting her daughter, Blue Ivy.
I am dying over this. I know. It's so sweet.
We've got all that plus so much more on today's Moms Like Us. Hi guys, welcome to Moms Like Us. I'm Mandy DeCamp here with Stroller in the City's Brianne Manns. Hi Brianne, happy Thursday.
Hey Mandy, how's it going?
Good, good. I want to get right into the celebrity mom and dad news of the week. We're starting with our interview with Coco Austin. So I don't know if you saw, but our interview last week went a little bit viral with her. She said that she still breastfeeds her five-year-old here and there, which we can talk about. But this other clip is her telling us their five-year-old Chanel also sleeps in the bed with her and iced tea. So let's take a look.
Yes, she sleeps with us. And I think that's another thing. Whenever she's feeling like she can do it on her own, she has her own room, she has her own bed, she takes naps in her own room. But, you know, like Isa and I, we have a different way of thinking. We call our bed the family bed. We have Chanel and all four dogs.
Oh, yes.
And if we feel comfortable with that, we feel comfortable with that. I mean, we have to set aside certain days. You know, we can't be really spontaneous anymore like we used to, but we assign certain days where we have a free bed, let's just say, for our alone times.
Right.
But we like the tribe feel.
Yes.
Does that sound weird? Like we like our family time.
Yeah, there are more families out there like you guys that I think people realize. Like, people mm-hmm. are sort of not listening to society anymore, and they're doing their own thing. Yeah. Whatever works for each family, you know?
Yeah, and also, like, this works for us, and it makes us happy. And again, we only have one child, and, you know, we like the feeling of the cuddliness and, you know, watching TV at night and bringing it together, because our lives are so sporadic during the day. We're not the normal couple. We're like always on the go. So at night, bringing it in with our family, that's our alone time without the world. We're like in our little bubble, you know. And, you know, Chanel, like I said, she has her own room. She can go in there whenever she wants and she takes her little naps, but we just like our alone time with our family.
All right. So how long did you let your kids sleep in the bed? What's your stance on that?
So my kids have always made their way into our bed, but I think that kind of stopped around like 3 years old. Okay. I want to say, so yeah. I get it. Like, I remember my mom always saying to me, like, do what works for you. Like, if your kid, if you're going to get sleep and your kid's like next to you in the bed, like you're going to get sleep, you know? So like, you know, it depends. Like, is her child getting up in the middle of the night? Cause he, you know, she's scared or what, you know, I don't know. Yeah. I kind of have to say just like, do what works for you, in my opinion.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I'm not there yet. You know, I like to think that Amelia will always sleep in her bed. It will be great. And she'll never use an iPad either, you know? My sisters all dealt with this. My brother dealt with it with their kids. I would say whatever works for you. It's funny though. She calls it like the family bed, which I'm just like, well, maybe I'd try to stop it. Maybe I would try to put the baby in her bed. But it sounds like they kind of parent their own way. And she said the reason for that is because they're always on tour. They're always on the road and it's not going to be the typical parenting. She also breastfeeds her five-year-old. So what are your thoughts on that?
That to me, I don't know. I kind of stopped when my kids were around like a year, maybe like a year and 2 months or so. Yeah. I mean, the five-year-olds, I don't know, going to kindergarten and still kind of breastfeeding is a little odd to me.
Yeah. Pick your own. You know, this is one of those things, there's never a wrong or right answer to it. It's definitely whatever works for you, but definitely not for me. Definitely not for me.
No. I feel like once they can like talk and we're done. We're done. Or go to school.
I mean, it's crazy though. The internet went crazy over that, her saying this. And to be honest, I just don't care that much what other people do. I don't know. I'm like, if that works, I mean, look.
Right. Yeah. Agree. Totally.
Same formula.
Exactly. Oh my God. Yes, exactly.
All right. What's next?
So Jason Momoa recently opened up to Entertainment Tonight about why he's not sure he wants his kids to follow his and his wife, Lisa Bonet's acting footsteps. He said, one of them wants to do it and I'm not a fan. I don't want them to. I don't know. I'll try my damnedest to keep them out of it. I love storytelling. I love theatrical things. I like directing and filmmaking, but I just want them to, you know, really go for other things. So I can see this. I feel like a lot of people in the industry want their kids to do something different, I think, because being in the spotlight and that whole thing, right?
Yeah, I 100% get it. I think to deal with that industry, I mean, I deal with it myself too on the other side, but to deal with it on the acting side and really succeed and become famous, I'm sure you see the worst of the worst of it. And it can be scary, and to have a child, you want to protect them from that. I mean, I certainly would never push it on a kid if I was in that situation. I actually recently sat down with Jesse McCartney too. Jesse is the pop star. He had that song Beautiful Soul in the early 2000s. You know, he has new music now too, which is awesome. But he doesn't have kids yet, but he's engaged, and him and his fiance have been together years. And they've definitely talked about having kids and talked about, you know, whether or not they'd let them go in the industry, because he got famous at such a young age. And like super famous, you know, where he would have girls screaming over him. So he told us whether or not he'd want his kids to do that. Let's take a look. You got so famous so young. Would you want that for your future children, or would you want to kind of stay away from that a little bit?
It's a really hard question to answer, because so much of the industry is like, I just feel like sheltering a child from the industry is incredibly hard to do, and you do grow up very, very quickly. It would be one of those things that I can't answer now. I'd have to like know when the time is right and know like the child that I'm talking with, and just kind of, I think it's an individual based decision. Like, you know, I think some kids maybe could be cut out for it and some aren't. But it's a lot of pressure, and it's even worse now with like social media and everything that's out there, and the constant ridicule and people constantly having an opinion, whether you ask for it or not, is just, it's a lot in your 20s and 30s to like read all that stuff. I can't imagine like, you know, a hormonal prepubescent teenager
reading
terrible comments. So I don't know. It's hard because you want to protect, right? I think is like your biggest goal as a parent, but it's hard in the industry where you grow up so quickly, but it just depends.
So he basically told us that he's not sure. It would obviously depend on the kid and their personality and how, if he thought they could take it, but he definitely seemed like he was erring on the side of not wanting that for his future kids.
I feel like the grass is always greener.
Yeah.
So like I can see, you know, really big celebrity with paparazzi like surrounding them, and we think it's so cool because we don't have it going on. Mm-hmm. And they're kind of like, this is annoying. Like we never have our privacy. So I can see it. I can see it.
Yeah. Yeah, totally. All right. Moving on to Beyonce. What did she do this
week? Yes. So Beyonce shared a sweet story about her 9-year-old daughter, Blue Ivy, in a rare interview with Harper's Bazaar. She said, one of the most satisfying moments as a mom is when I found Blue one day soaking in a bath with her eyes closed, using blends I created and taking time for herself to decompress and be at peace, which I'm like dying.
I can picture this.
I can totally picture this in like a big, huge tub, like amazing, but like my daughter does this. So I can totally appreciate it. My daughter's 10 and she loves to like, she'll put like the mask on her face, you know, and she like loves to do this, which is something that I feel like I don't even find time to do, but she.
Yeah. That's hysterical.
So this singer has been creating similar positive rituals for herself since the coronavirus quarantine and loves that Blue and her little sister Rumi will have the example of those. She said, I discovered CBD on my last tour and I've experienced its benefits for soreness and inflammation. It helped with my restless nights and the agitation that comes from not being able to fall asleep. I found healing properties in honey that benefit me and my children. And now I'm building a hemp and honey farm. I've got hives on my roof. I am dying over this. I can't even. It's so sweet.
I love it. I mean, I want Beyonce's life. I want a hemp and honey farm too. I
mean, how do we do this, Beyonce? Tell us, how do we start one of these? Because I want one too.
Yeah, that I love that her daughters are taking after her and pampering themselves. And I do think it's important for young girls to do that and figure out, you know, face masks and bubble baths and have fun with that and just be themselves. That's awesome. I have not done the CBD trend. I know it's been around for a while now. Is that something you get behind? I'm not that I'm opposed to it. I just haven't tried.
I feel like I haven't, like, I don't think I like know so much about it. Like I've taken like a CBD, like a sleep gummy once in a while. I'm almost like afraid, cause I feel like people who take like melatonin all the time can get like hooked on something. And I'm not that person. I don't just take like Advil or Tylenol, like, you know, headaches. I kind of just like get through it.
Yeah.
So, but I have heard like amazing things about CBD. Yeah. I do like the CBD, like oil for your back, like that I'll get behind once in a while.
Yeah.
But I feel like I need to look more into it because I feel like people who are taking it are so chill. And I think I kind of need to be more chill.
I have been wanting to get CBD pills for my dog for ages now because she's so high strung. I'm going to try it. I'll report back.
Yes, report back. I want to know.
In today's Say Aw moment of the week, we're looking at Nikki Bella's recent family vacation to Lake Tahoe. So I'm obsessed with Lake Tahoe between her videos and the recent episode of Beverly Hills Housewives where they went.
Yes. It looks gorgeous. I totally agree.
Have you been?
I have not been there. No.
Wow.
There
you go. Beautiful. Yeah. So she shared videos from the trip showing her adorable son, Mateo, with dad, Artem. She wrote, you know, it's a good vacation when you keep reminiscing and looking at pictures and photos. I miss my family. I miss Lake Tahoe. I miss the smell. I miss and love all the memories I created with Artem, Mateo, and my whole family. Tahoe has always had my favorite and best childhood memories. Love keeping the tradition going. So cute that her videos were just so adorable. What's your favorite family vacation for summer or winter?
Summer or winter. Oh my God. I love it all. I mean, we went to Italy 2 years ago, so that was just magical during the summer. We went to Capri and like the entire Amalfi Coast. I mean, that was just absolutely magical. I feel like I want to go back there.
Did your kids appreciate it? Because I always worry about like the kind of more expensive, more elaborate vacations, if kids appreciate it or were they at a good age?
I know that they appreciate it when they talk about it, like in reference to something like, remember we went to Italy and this, or remember we ate this. So yeah, I love traveling with my kids. I mean, it's something that we haven't done in a year. I'm like dying to get back to doing it.
No,
but I love traveling. I think they do appreciate it, especially now. I think you have to go when they're like five and up.
Yeah.
It's not, especially like to Europe, to like walking trips, you know? Yeah. So I feel like that they'll start appreciating it by like five.
Yeah.
Could they remember where they went when they were like two and three? No, definitely not.
Yeah. Jeffrey and I are just dying to take Amelia to Disney World because we want to go, but we're like, she probably won't care until she's like four or five, but we're going next year.
Like it or not, Amelia. Yeah.
I love for family, like an easy summer family vacation to me is Newport, Rhode Island. It's just one of our favorites. I went there as a kid with my family and I remember it. I remember specific memories. Like she said, you remember the smell, you remember, you know, everything makes you nostalgic when you think about it. And then that's where Jeffrey and I got engaged. And that's also where we went on our baby moon. So it's just like, got a place near and dear to my heart, but I think it's one of those towns that it's good for adults because you have tons of bars and restaurants, but it's also fun for kids because you can explore the mansions, the water, all of that.
Yeah. Anything with a beach, I feel like my kids are all about. Like they just like want to be in the ocean. They want the waves. They want to like ride their boogie boards. Like they're so into that. Like we took them to a bay beach the other day and they were like, there's no waves here. I'm like, oh, like, let's relax today. Yeah. I don't feel like watching you in the waves. It's too scary. Okay, so today's clapback of the week goes to Emily Ratajkowski. She wrote on her Instagram, "We are reflecting back on shaming Britney Spears and calling her a bad mom. We talk about how we have to do better as a culture. Meanwhile, my comments are filled with awful remarks about how I don't deserve to be a mom. Shame on you all. I don't care if you hate me or hate celebrity or just hate women, but it's incredibly scary to become a parent, and no one deserves to be told by strangers that they're a shitty mother." The actress's social media upload came 1 month after she shared a photo holding her baby in one arm while showing off their matching swimsuits via Instagram. People quickly flooded her comments, and even Piers Morgan tweeted, "That's not how you hold a baby, and your millions of followers shouldn't be encouraged to do the same. Happy to give you some tips if you need them." So let's discuss. What did you think of this photo?
Okay, so we can't show the photo because I believe she's removed it since, but it was basically her standing and the baby's head was tilted down a bit. The baby's young, you know, you're supposed to support their neck. Obviously, she's a model. She looks amazing in the photo, and the baby does too. Like, it's a gorgeous photo. The photo was a bit much for me, I have to say. It was a little bit like, you know, people are going to say something. You are in the public eye, you know, you're a public figure. So I understand, like, I don't understand people attacking her. The baby was not in true danger, I don't think. But you do have to understand, by uploading that photo, people are going to comment because you're a celebrity.
Yes, so I agree with you. Yeah. It's the same thing as, like, you know, showing a baby in a car seat and, you know, you're not driving, the baby's not even in the car and the straps are not the right way. People are going to come after you. People have come after me for that. Like, I get it.
When Amelia was like not even moving yet, I uploaded a photo of her sitting in one of her seats, not strapped in. And I had a friend comment saying, "What, you got to strap her in?" I'm like, "What?" Like, she's not even moving it. I know my baby. And I'm sure that's what she feels too. I know my baby. You don't know her or him. And I know what I'm doing. And I'm sure she would never put her baby in danger. It's not about that. It's just knowing that you're a celebrity and you have millions of followers, people are going to comment. Now, Piers Morgan tweeting, back off, Piers.
that was kind of odd. I thought that was odd.
But he likes to stir up controversy.
Yep. Loves it.
All right. Well, thank you, Brianne. And thanks to all of our guests today. And make sure to tune back every Thursday at 3 p.m. on Us Weekly's YouTube channel. And don't forget to subscribe and like below. Bye, guys.